Hey guys, and welcome back to a brand new video. Last time we made the painter skin, which actually got in the game. In this episode, I want to talk about our design thinking and how we built the student skin. Now, I want to point out, unlike the painter skin, the student skin is not in the game. And as far as I am aware, there are no plans of adding it to the game. But nonetheless, I still want to go over the design thinking and how we made it, because it might help you guys out when making your own skins. Without further ado, let's jump straight into it. So, first of all, we went back to the trusty Maya. And what I wanted to do is I wanted to give Voca long hair for the skin. So at first I tried a lot of different methods to see what looked good, but they didn't really work out the way I wanted it to. And next up was the glasses. I really wanted to give a student Voca glasses. So we took a reference of glasses and we made them. And making the glasses wasn't too difficult, but it took a lot of time, more than I expected it to, because we really wanted to have all the curves and like the natural feeling of glasses in the model. I also wanted to make sure that the model was as optimized as possible, so we also went back and optimized it a little bit. So after that, we just mirrored it to get the other one in, and it was pretty easy. There was something else that I really wanted to do though, and that was to give the glasses a little bit more of a curvature so it fits around the head better. So guess what we did, and well, basically the glasses were done at this point, but they felt a little bit dull and boring, so I thought, you know, maybe we can add like the little star thingies on top, see how that looks, and it looks actually pretty good. Now, of course, when you are 3D modeling, there is something that you gotta do, which is also super lame and boring, and that is UV mapping, because it is so important. So, we started to UV map for the glasses. I think the UV map turned out okay. It isn't the best UV map in the world, but it's certainly really good. So after that we went to Substance Painter, and Substance Painter is a program that literally allows you to draw on top of the model, which is super cool. This is the first time I ever used Substance Painter, so it was a lot to figure out, but I'm actually quite happy with how it turned out. We actually really wanted to try and have like this classic schoolgirl look like from animes that you see, so we went with the necktie and like the skirt, which was pretty easy because Voca normally always wears a skirt, so that was pretty cool. I decided to draw it on a lot of different layers so we always could go back and change something without ruining the rest of the picture, which was pretty cool. So after we colored everything, we just turned all the layers back on, and all was left to do was the hair and the glasses. I really wanted to give her red hair, as we don't have a Voca skin with red hair yet, and I thought it looked pretty cool. And here we have student Voca in all her glory. And I gotta say, I'm pretty happy how it turned out. I absolutely love the little socks I gave her, and once again, I'm just a sucker for the long red hair and glasses. I think it looks really cool. Looking back, I think I should have put more effort in the party popper, as it's just a solid color. Now, don't get me wrong, a lot of skins in Tower Heroes have the party popper just one color, but for some reason, it feels a little bit off. But other than that, I'm quite happy with how it turned out. But anyway guys, thank you all so much for watching. If you like this video and want to see more, please hit that like and subscribe button. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye!